Welcome to the Jones Invitational American Rules Croquet Tournament put on by the Sarasota County Croquet Club in Venice, Florida in early 2020. Hans Peterson is the tournament director and Nancy Hart the tournament manager. This edition of the event is dedicated to the memory of Fred Jones, the co-founder along with his wife Jackie of the event and the venue. Fred was everybody's mentor in American croquet, and he passed away in November of 2019. This game is from block play in the championship B flight between Bob Crouch and Brett Stovall with their respective handicaps. Bob Crouch coming in with blue. The out game is pretty popular these days, but I don't think that's what he was trying to do. Pretty nice little jump shot. I'm not really sure, but I think blue is probably too well positioned for him to risk setting up in front of hoop two. So after four turns, there's only one ball in the game. This will be the deadness board, which will also show clip position. Interesting. Blue's in good position, so this is no safer than it was the first time. But he almost made the hoop from corner one. He must play a lot of golf croquet. Trying a block from 90 degrees is tough. Shades of Mick Mihas, the bad boy of croquet a couple decades ago. Now it's apparent why he thought he could put red there, because he knew he could clear blue. there's no downside to this shot as long as you don't hit the hoop and stay close. Whoops. He does like those long hoop shots. He could have set up, because even if black hit him, it wouldn't have been much of a disadvantage. Very nice touch. I had to do some pretty aggressive editing in this video because they're double banking, but you can certainly appreciate Brian Hovis's excellent camera work. That ball's going out. He couldn't have afforded to set up at hoop five anyway because of the nice position of black. Probably would have just gone to the east boundary to keep Crouch from setting up at hoop four. Trying for the stop shot. Black could set up here, but with yellow ready to come in with no problem, all yellow would have to do is go to red, and red's got a three ball break, so not a good idea. Going to yellow's next hoop. And finally, all four balls are in the game. At hoops 2, 3, 4, and 5. They spent the next 3 minutes, 4 or 5 turns, I think, setting leaves, waiting for somebody to pull the trigger. In general, you're going to hit first the ball you want to leave behind. Because that was a takeoff to the attack, then you would hit the danger ball first. If it's a rush to the attack, you hit the spent ball first because you're going to leave it behind with your partner. Ooh, he's set up to row K yellow over to black after he makes the hoop. Then he could hide blue wired from red and get a three ball break. Black is for hoop four, of course. Or just count on black to row K yellow. But he didn't want to leave blue out as a pioneer at four because red was too close. I only left this in because I could not figure out what the devil they were talking about. Looks like two guys playing doubles. Nothing changed. That board's just a reminder of the state of the game. And now we're tied. He's going to take this shot at red because blue is right near hoop four, his next hoop. Had he left red off the line a foot and a half instead of 9 inches, it would have made it easier to hit. And the opponent still would have been unlikely to come get it. Britt Ruby does that at hoop one all the time. Hoping, of course, that the opponent doesn't even notice. I think this qualifies as a rush to the attack. So he wants to hit blue first, and he did. Looks like Crouch, the opponent, is the one who suggested calling a referee, and that referee must have been paying close attention. Crouch probably called the referee because a mallet fault, hitting the third ball with your mallet, is pretty easy in this hampered situation. Oh no, red and blue weren't in contact. That's a fault in American rules. In AC, it's not if you have made an effort to put those two balls together, as long as you move the second ball, of course. I've never been this far into a video game before I had to put up any balls on the deadness part of the board. Interesting. The ref's not watching. A fault is just as likely here as it was before. He's not worried about giving opponent a one back clearance because he has a three ball break in progress. That's not what he wanted Yellow to do, but it's actually not so bad because now he can leave the danger ball down here at the end of the court and set a nice leave on the south boundary. He does have to get Yellow out of the jaws, though. Nice turn, three hoops. The danger ball is a long way away. He got opponent dead, but he's still alive on partner. Missing by the proverbial coat of paint. Now that's a revolting development. That reference probably tells you how old I am. I forgot to mention that Red took the one back clearance at the appropriate time. It's funny how you miss shorter shots by more than you sometimes miss really long shots. And all of his short misses have been to the right. There's no pioneer at three back, and his only rush is to the danger ball, so. I guess he's guarding Yellow's approach to hoop five, but if If Red wanted a Roquet yellow now, he could do a Croquet out. Drop yellow out of bounds next to blue while Red is on its way to five. Looks like black passes. I think he just didn't want to walk all the way down there. Black is for three back. He could have left those balls just the way they were, rushed blue down to four back, and then made three back off yellow and gotten a three ball break going. Would have made him harder to pick up as well. Brian's camera is on the north boundary, which is about 50 feet from a major boulevard in Venice, so it makes the background noise a pain to have to deal with. He's missed that hoop on the right stanchion twice now. Might be something there he can fix. Now blue and black both have deadness rotation. Bad place for red and yellow to be in. Bob's very accurate with that grip halfway down the shaft, but it doesn't make for a very good stop shot ratio. If he was going to keep the break going, he would have put yellow on the other side of the hoop. With those two partner dead and red three ball dead, he probably doesn't want to make one back, even with a break. And now he can take black to the peg and easily do a killer leave because of all the deadness. Red and yellow are both for hoop five, of course. I'll bet he'd like to have that over. A gentler stroke, he would have had a rush on blue to four back. The third time for the right stanchion. Red's three ball dead, so he can put all these balls out there with impunity. Another option here would be to aim blue right at Pinault and then do a little stop shot aiming the mallet just outside the tangent line. That would put blue in a much better position to continue the break. The tangent line is the line between the two balls that is the dividing point between a split shot and a takeoff. That wave of the arm was acknowledging a time announcement, I think 5 minutes.
How much time do you say? 5 minutes.
I got an hour 11, so I've got one or two times.
Or maybe he planned all along to leave yellow in escape ball position after he drops blue off next to red after he makes Pinault. But that wouldn't make any sense because putting blue back by red would only be to get a break going with blue, which when you make one back would allow red to be cleared of deadness, and that would be silly this late in the game. They must be in last turns or pretty close to it. What a shot. He should save that for when he really needs it. Bob Crouch over Brett Stovall, 18-8. These two finished right in the middle of the pack in the championship B block. Crouch one place above Stovall. Thanks so much for watching. Check out the other games from the Jones Invitational in the playlist. And once again, in memory of Fred Jones.